Leaders of the financial world descend on Paris for a climate economy summit. The two-day conference seeks to overhaul monetary institutions to address the world's problem on climate change and poverty. Among the attendees is U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen. She urged multilateral lenders to be more effective in using their funds.
Countries cannot sustainably bring down poverty rates and invest in their growth if they constantly face shocks from climate change, pandemics, or conflict. MDBs need to evolve to incorporate addressing these global challenges into their work. This includes reforming their vision, incentive structures, their operating model, and financing capacity to help countries fight these challenges and build resilience.
World Bank President Ajay Banga, meanwhile, announced a plan to ease debt payments for crisis-hit nations.
Today, we are announcing a comprehensive approach that significantly expands the World Bank's toolkit for crisis preparedness, response, and recovery. What are we going to do? First, help governments build advanced emergency systems so they are ready to respond on day one. Two, provide new types of insurance that will backstop development projects. And most importantly, offer a pause in debt repayments so countries can focus on what matters to their leaders when a crisis hits and stop worrying about the bill that's going to come with that crisis.
Stocks in Asia capped the trading week in the red as investors react to the latest economic data from Japan. Tokyo's inflation in May slightly eased to 3.2%, but remained above the Bank of Japan's target of 2%. Traders are also reacting to flash estimates from the AU Jibun Bank, which show Japan's business activity expanding at a slower rate in June. Taking a look now at major stock indices in the region, we're seeing the Nikkei 225 declining by 1.4% on Friday. Also seeing huge losses are the Hong Kong's Hang Seng, as well as Australia's ASX 200. It's a similar showing in Europe, but markets there are particularly reacting to the Bank of England's fresh rate hike as Britain's inflation remained high last month. As for Wall Street, it's also headed to a weaker session when trading resumes tonight, Manila time. The Philippine Audit Commission flags the Sugar Regulatory Administration for deficiencies in its block farm program, which aims to boost the local production of the sweetener. The agency says over 326 million pesos were spent in the Visayas for the procurement of machineries and equipment for irrigation facilities. But it adds two of these facilities remain idle due to lack of water resources and the leasing out of farm implements by the associations. The agency also notes suppliers and SRA personnel lack training on the usage of agriculture machineries, which resulted in a low performance rate. The Philippine government is urged to do more to attract foreign investors to the country. Our correspondent Jackie Pascual joins us on the line for more on this story. Hi, Jackie, go ahead.
Hi, Stanley. Good afternoon. The Philippines should do more to attract foreign investments. DPI economists June Neri and Marco Avierseb, the country still lags behind foreign investments compared to neighboring countries in Southeast Asia. At a virtual media briefing earlier, both economists pointed to the many challenges faced by investors that have been a problem for decades already. Among these issues are poor infrastructure and the slow and tedious government processes, both at the national level and at the local government unit level. For example, they said infrastructure spending in terms of percentage to GDP is still very low, and the getting of permits from LGUs to put up factories and other businesses is also taking so long. And there is also an issue with the right of way for rails or roads. And they also add that the high cost of power, which can be problematic if El Nino reaches summer season next year, because then the country would have to rely more on expensive forms of energy if the hydropower is affected. Now, Stanley, they also mentioned that the problems, of course, in the health sector and education, asserting investors are also looking at human capital development of a country before they will invest. So he mentioned that education sector must be upgraded. Economists hope that the government will address these issues in order to attract more foreign investments. The government has said that they are working to improve all sectors, including health and education, as they also try to attract more foreign businesses to invest in the Philippines. And that's the latest. Stanley, back to you.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Jackie Pascual.